Steve Dotto here, glad you could join me today. Today I want to talk about Evernote Web Clipper, one of my favorite tools, and a new version of it is available as of, well, for me, last night. I use the Chrome browser, and actually, a funny story, I'll share it with you. I was giving a talk last night, doing a presentation to a group of accountants, such a party group, and I was showing them productivity tools, as I often do, and I thought I would show them Evernote, as I often do, because it's such a great productivity tool. And I was talking about the Evernote Web Clipper, which, if you look at our previous videos, you know is a tremendous tool, and except Evernote had upgraded it without, I hadn't noticed. And so when I clicked on it, instead of Evernote running with a normal screen, or the Evernote Web Clipper with a normal little screen in the middle for me to capture whatever I wanted, it ran an installation process, which bamboozled me briefly, because I couldn't figure out what was going on, and of course I'm trying to talk and trying to install at the same time, which is never a good combination. And then I got through it, and the interface is brand new. And so, of course, I botched the demo, didn't look like an expert at all. And I like most of the things in it, some things not so much. But for you, if you're using Chrome, you can install the Evernote Web Clipper if you haven't installed it, or you'll be asked to upgrade if you already have Chrome running. Depending on when you're watching this, it might be available in other browsers as well. Full disclosure, this is September 13th, 2013 that I'm recording this. So depending on when you are watching it, you may indeed have a version or this version in your browser as well, your browser of choice. But let's take a look at it. If you've followed any of our other videos or you're an Evernote user, you know Evernote Web Clipper is this tremendous tool that installs in your browser's menu bar or toolbar, and it allows you to basically capture and clip different things that you find online and store them in your Evernote notebook. And it works. It's just a terrific research tool. It's a terrific tool for doing just capturing all the different pieces of information, putting them in one place so that you can find them again in the future. One of my favorite tools, actually. But now it looks different. So I'm going to click on it right here, clip to Evernote, which is the same as it's always been. And now it does a few things. I'm still kind of figuring out the interface. So you'll have to excuse me if I make a few little mistakes. But what it did right away, as soon as I clipped it, is it took a screenshot of my entire screen. That's new. It didn't used to do that. It used to bring up an option that allowed you to marquee the area that you wanted to take a screenshot. I'm not sure I love this option or not. I still haven't really integrated it in my process. But this is what's brand new. Is instead of having the Evernote Web Clipper tools appear in the middle of the screen, now it's in this bar that slides out from the side of your browser that you see here. And we see our options as far as doing capture. Now, it's by default set to screenshot. If I actually choose one of these different presets, it won't take that screenshot right away. And I should point out that screenshot is now only in Evernote's memory. It hasn't been saved anywhere until we actually save it. So if I escape out of this, I haven't saved a screenshot onto my desktop or into Evernote or anything else. It's just in the clipboard right now. So here's my options for gathering for capturing this page. And I like some of these things, and they've integrated some of the tools from some of their other utilities as well, such as Evernote Clearly. Look, if I choose to view this page as a simplified article, it will take out all of the extraneous information and just the core information. So things like advertising and all those extra things will be removed from the page if I choose to view the simplified article, which is often what you're going to want to do. Now, let me give you a better example of how this might work. I'm going to go back into just my normal browser, and I'm going to go to a page. Typically, as you're browsing around finding information, you might be reading about some science article here on ZDNet. And if I was to clip this page into my Evernote notebook, I would have all of these advertisements, I'd have all the related stories, I'd have all of this extra information that's on this web page. Watch what happens when I click on Evernote and then I choose Simplified Article. It will now strip all of that extra information away. And now if I decide to save this, I've just got the meat of the story. That to me is a really elegant use of Evernote. Now that is incorporating a tool or a utility that Evernote's been building for a long time. This little lamp icon here, that's called Evernote Clearly, and that has allowed us to go to web pages and strip the extraneous information out while we're reading them for a very long time. Now before I move on, let's just talk about what we do with this once we've got the article that we want. We can still save it and share it. So we can, if I click save, I can save it to whatever notebook I want within my Evernote notebook. I'm not going to go into too much detail there, but look at the new sharing window. When I call up sharing, it then saves the clip and it allows me to share it in Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, or send it to email. So that gives me some really nice social sharing and email sharing options with this particular document. Now, when it shares it, it's not going to send the entire document with all the photos. Instead, what it's going to do is it's going to share an Evernote link, which means it's going to save it in your notebook, and then it's going to send a link, make that a shared link, send it to other people so they have to click on that link, and then they can see all of the information. It's actually quite elegant. Now, Evernote has integrated clearly, as you can see, with the Evernote Web Clipper. The other thing that they've integrated with it is they've integrated a lot of what's called Sketch. Now, Sketch is Evernote's tool that allows me to mark up different screenshots. So when I click on the screenshot capture, as soon as I do that, before I do anything else with it, I can now mark it up and start to use these tools here, these markup tools, to be able to talk about what's in the document, make notes, and be able to basically mark up whatever it is. I'm going to type in markup because that's what I'm doing. And I've chosen a nice hot pink color. Hot pink. That's the button I want to click on. I do want to show you one other thing. Sorry, I forgot. If we go back into the menu here, if we choose bookmark, it then captures some extra information about the website, and it captures and saves it as a bookmark within your Evernote notebook. And that's, for me, that's the best way to save bookmarks rather than saving them in the web browser, because I've always got Evernote with me, and it just makes it more elegant as far as sharing and remembering where different bookmarks are. The one thing that I'm not sure I'm crazy about. If we go back into the screenshot mode where we're taking a screenshot of it, if we want to anything below the fold, we have to choose full page here from the menu. And so it doesn't make it quite as elegant for just highlighting an area of a page and saving it. But once you have taken a screenshot, you can crop it using the tools that came over from Sketch. So you can actually crop the page if you choose to, with the using the different cropping tools here, to be able to choose to just save a smaller part of the page. So I think we've lost a little bit. We've lost that ability to just be able to click on a page, highlight what you want to copy, and then copy it really quickly. That was always really efficient. But if you think about copying more information and more organization in your clipping from the web, I think that they've dramatically improved things with the new Evernote Web Clipper. Before you leave, give me 30 seconds. I have one question for you. I want to know, how's your email inbox looking? Is it in great shape? No, it's not, is it? Very few of us really have control over our email inbox. In fact, I think email is probably the biggest productivity parasite on the planet. But I have great news. I have put together a free one-hour webinar called 3 Steps to Inbox Zero, which teaches you everything that you need to know to get control of your email inbox. It will get you on the path towards less stress, less pressure, more productivity. It's a great webinar. The link is right here. Just click on it. It'll take you right to it. It's free to register, free to take the course. It's 1 hour long. I think if you take it, you will find that it is probably the best hour that you can spend this week.